Multi-drug-resistant bacteria, a major public health problem. So I'm from Greece, and I think also not only because of this, but also because of the resistant rates. Greece is the most good example if we want to check why resistant to antibiotics is important. So multi-drug-resistant bacteria are usually resistant to beta-lactams and often to other antibiotics as fluoroquinolones and aminoglycosides. And this means that they leave very few treatment options to the doctor. First outbreaks of extended-spectrum beta-lactamase producers were described in mid-1980s in France and after some time in United States of America. And now ESBL producers are widespread worldwide and usually are often multi-drug resistant. Carbapenemase producing Enterobacteriaceae became a health issue problem the last 20 years. And the first report of an EM-producing strain was the Serratia marcescens strain, which was isolated in Japan, and it was reported in 1994. A few years after the detection of carbapenemase in clinical use in 1985. Carbapenemases are beta-lactamases which can hydrolyze beta-carbapenems, and the most important from epidemiological view are beta-lactamases are falling into three classes. Class B, which includes beta-lactamases, with the most important of them being IMP, VIM, and DM. Class A, with the most important being the KPCs. However, there are some other beta-lactamases which pose minor problems, as GERS, SME, and MCA, and IMI. And class D, carbapenemases, which are mainly based on OXA-type carbapenemases, which are found in Acinetobacter species, and OXA-48-type beta-lactamases, which are mainly found in the Enterobacteriaceae species. In 2013, a survey was organized by Eurosurveillance, and in this survey, national experts from all European countries had to self-assess the situation of carbapenemase-producing enterobacteria in their countries. And this is the map which was constructed after this self-assessment. And as you can see, only Italy and Greece and Malta are colored with red, which means that the situation in these countries are endemic for carbapenemase-producing bacteria. If we're going to have to understand what is the situation in Greece, we must have a look in the clinical important beta-lactamases in Greek hospitals. And with this figure, I try to show you which were the most important beta-lactamases according to the period. So this means that until 2001, the most important beta-lactamases was extended-spectrum beta-lactamases, with the predominant being SHB5, and also were isolated some CTX-ME and GES, while after the introduction in 2001 of VIM-1, of VIM beta-lactamases, the most important was VIM-1, and then after 2007, when the introduction of KPC happened, the most important is KPC. And so we'll have a review of this period after 2001, with the findings of a high evolution of this situation. The problem of MBL-producing bacteria in Europe was originally confined to Pseudomonas aeruginosa isolates, and the first two reports was in 1999 from Loretto, where they described they characterized the VIM-1 metallo-beta-lactamase from a Pseudomonas aeruginosa isolate, which was found in Verona University Hospital in 1997. And the second report was from Poirel in 2000, which characterized VIM-2 metallo-beta-lactamase, again from a Pseudomonas aeruginosa isolate, which was found in France in 1966. While in Greece, the first outbreak of Pseudomonas aeruginosa harboring MBL occurred in a hospital in Thessaloniki in 1996, and it was reported in 2000. Later, the enzyme was characterized as VIM2, and in 2001, the survey reported that VIM2's monosaragginosa were isolated in 9 out of the 18 hospitals examined. This data shows that the Greek system failed to recognize the VIM-producing bacteria and to organize some guidelines or surveys in order to prevent this establishment of the resistant mechanism. But the most important thing in the history of, history of the Greek hospitals is the VIM-producing Enterobacteriaceae. The first VIM-producing bacterium was an Escherichia coli, isolated in November 2001, and then a lot of sporadic isolates and hospital outbreaks were reported. While the first Klebsiella pneumonia derived bacteria were reported in 2003, and also some other VIM-producing derived bacteria were reported as Proteus mirabilis, Derobacter cloaca, Derobacter aeruginous, Morganella morgani, and I think Ceratia marcensis. However, the main problem was VIM-producing Klebsiella pneumonia for the Greek hospitals. And from this figure, I tried to show you, which is from the Greek system for antimicrobial resistance. I would like to show you that how the imipenem-resistant bacteria increased from 2001, which were less than 1%, to 20% in 2006. Isolating in hospital wards, while the percent was 50% for isolates from ICUs. And also this means it could be translated that the first isolates of imipenem resistant Klebsiella in 2002 were reported from 3 hospitals, while in 2006 more than 25 hospitals from the hospitals that were participating in this system reported VIM-producing bacteria. Also, it's important to mention that such increase was not reported for other enteric bacteria, meaning Escherichia coli or Proteus. This increase was only reported for Klebsiella. Again, in this figure, we saw the proportion of carbapenem-resistant Klebsiella in nearest participating countries in 2006. And from the coloring, we can see that only Greece is painted blue, which means that the percentage is very high, while some sporadic cases and small outbreaks were reported from Italy, Spain, and France. And in some of these cases, we could trace back the isolates to Greece. This means that isolates were from Greek patients who traveled to other countries. And this is not only, this means that VIM producing or carbapenem producing bacteria it's not a public health problem only for Greece, but this could be also a problem for other countries, as with the movement of the patients could be isolated and established to the other countries. However, it's important if we want to understand how an epidemic works to understand also the genetic or the molecular characteristics of this epidemic. And the most important notes for this epidemic was that VIM1 was the dominant beta-lactamase among the MBL-producing enterobacteria circulating in Greece, while for Pseudomonas was VIM2. Of course, there were some other also variants reported, but these were sporadic. Also important is to understand that BLAVIM1 gene was found as a gene cast in class 1 in the ground, which was named as in E541, and this intergrown harbored also other resistant gene casts as AAC7, DFR1, and AADH, which confer resistance to aminococytes and trimethoprim. And the other important thing is that BLAVIM1 carrying plasmids belong to incompatibility group, suggesting a plasmic epidemic. However, by this slide, I would like to show you that this is that there was a big variability in the plasmid scaffold of the Incan plasmids, encoding VIM-1. And as you can see, there were six types of VIM encoding plasmids, while all of them harbored the same integrons. This means that they were variations on the same scaffold, and this probably was done by some rearrangements or deletions of the, because of the insertion sequence that they were found on the plasmids. And also, it can be shown here, it's the same shown here. And the important thing with this slide is that here we can see that the presence of an insertion sequence after hybridization of insertion sequence IS26, and this can explain the why this variability was observed there. And also we can see a duplication of the VIM encoding integron. So this explains why these plasmids were so variable. And this also was seen after the characterization of the complete nucleotide sequence of the plasmid. And after, when we characterized the complete nucleotide sequence, we saw that the integron was bounded by two copies of IS26, which this means that the integron could move to other mobile elements or to other plasmids or to other sites inside the same molecule. So PFG typing of beam-producing Klebsiellas demonstrated that beam epidemic was seemed to be due to the dissemination of several distinct clones. This period, multilocal sequence typing was not so available. So recent studies from other groups from Scandinavian region showed that several clones, as sequence type 147, 17, and 14, were responsible for the dissemination of blood beam during the peak of the Greek epidemic. So these two data are in agreement. These were the most important notes for the VIM epidemic. While if we want to change the page and to go to KPC epidemic, the first, the Greek system understood that there was a new resistant mechanism after the first reports of KPC producing isolates from Greek patients that traveled to other European countries. And after that, a nationwide surveillance revealed was organized and revealed the parallel epidemic of KPC producers, and I mean parallel because of the VIM epidemic and the KPC epidemic. And the same period, the first outbreak of KPC2 producing Klebsiellas was seen in a hospital in Crete. The importance of why I'm mentioning Crete is that Crete is near Israel. And the same period in Israel, the KPC epidemic was almost on the peak. So a lot of people from Greece believe that the epidemic moved from Israel to Crete via tourists. And finally, in 2009, the emergence of Klebsiella pneumoniae isolates co-producing KPC and VIM-1 was reported. As we observed again, the peak system was delayed to recognize the insertion of a new resistant mechanism, and this allowed the spread and the establishment of this mechanism. However, surveillance for antimicrobial resistance was organized, and various guidelines, including advice on antibiotic policy and infection control, was developed by the National Center for Disease Control and Prevention. If we want to see the major characteristics, if for showing you the major characteristics, I would like to use a specific study, which was published in 2011. And in this study, they collected 378 isolates from 2009 to 2010. All of them were black KPC positive, while 18 of them simultaneously produced VIM-1 or VIM-4. As you can see from the map, most of them were isolated from the whole Greece. And PFG typing classified the isolates in 13 PFG types, with the predominant being the PFG type 1 with 322 isolates, and representative isolates from this PFG type were classified as sequence type 258, while gene production was found in isolates of sequence type 147 and 323, and of VIM4 in 383. So I think one isolate of this sequence type was isolated also in your country, and this was from a patient from Greece. Is this correct?
Yes, it is.
These results show that KPC epidemic is clonal in Greece, and also that the spread also showed the spread of KPC encoding plasmids in a wide variety of sequence type, which shows the development of the epidemic, and this makes probably the situation more difficult. In fast, but I'll tell you only the important things. The importance of this is that almost all of the isolates had the same transposon element encoding KPC2, except of two isolates which belong to the same to the sequence type 340. The difference in the transposon element is only the deletion of 100 base pairs, and this deletion is important only because they showed that this deletion increases the production of KPC and also the resistance level to beta-lactams. The other thing from this slide is that all of the isolates harbor the same plasmids with the same PFG with the same RFLP patterns, and again these two isolates have different plasmids. There are no. Here is a slide just showing that all of the plasmids, they are representative isolates of course, but all of them had the same RFLP pattern. And here I try to show you that here are Greek plasmids from Greek isolates, and here are plasmids from Italian isolates. If we try to compare them, and in Greek plasmids has no variability, while the Italian plasmids are a bit more variable. However, from sequencing we saw that more than 90% of the Greek plasmids were similar to the previously described pequil type plasmid, and I know from my Italian colleagues that also the same is with the Italian plasmid. There are only some rearrangements because of movement of the transposonal elements or deletions. So all of this data show a continuously evolving situation which requires a screening, and that's why we wanted to see what was the prevalence of clinical important beta-lactamases in a recent sample. That's why we collected 256 isolates in 1 month from 8 general hospitals. And we saw that 158 isolates, meaning 6% of them, were non-susceptible to at least one expanded spectrum cephalosporin, and 132 of them were positive for a capenamase gene, meaning KPC or VIM. 40 of them were positive for KPC, 8% of them were positive for BLAVIM, and 3% of them were positive for both genes. By EIF and PCR, we saw that 128 isolates of them produced also other beta-lactamases, which are SHV, CMYs, TXMe, VEB, or SHV5. So from this table, we can see that there were observed 22 combinations of beta-lactamase production, and the most prevalent was the production of KPC plus SHV12 together, which was observed in 85 of the isolates. In order to conclude of this study, we observed that 43% of the KPC were KPC producers, and this shows how fast the percentage of KPC increased, because this study was done in 2011 and the introduction was in 2007 of the first isolate. While VIM producers were decreased in 11%, while in 2006 their percentage was 37%. One Another one important thing is that the high mortality observed about KPC producers, which ranges about 40 to 45% observed for patients with bloodstream infections. So a group from Greece tried to answer to why this high mortality, and they tried to see if there are some virulence, if there is some virulence traits to this Klebsiella sequence type 258. So they tried to see if to assess the virulence of this sequence type 58 by using a representative isolate in an animal model of mice, and they saw, and as you can see from the figures, the representative isolate of sequence type 258 could not kill the mice, the immunocompetent mice, while the doses that they used to kill the immunocompromised mice were very high. While the HCC strain had to use less inoculum to kill the mice. Also, they tested the sequence type, the Klebsiella sequence type 258 against the human serum, and as you can see, after 3 hours, the inoculum of the representative isolate was killed after 3 hours, while the HCC strain was not affected of the human serum after 3 hours. And also they saw, they tested the sequence type 258 Klebsiella pneumoniae against they measured the rate of phagocytosis, and against the same they found that sequence type 258 was not affected by phagocytosis, while 75% of the sequence type 258 was internalized after 15 minutes. Also, capsular typing of sequence type 258 isolates classified the microorganisms as K41, which is not among the virulent capsular types. This data suggests that this sequence type 258 exhibits very low virulence, and the high mortality attributed to this sequence type may be explained by the low efficacy of antimicrobials used against KPC-producing infections and the severity of the underlying conditions of the patients. So if we go back to this survey done in 2013, 33 of the countries reported that Klebsiella was the most frequent enterobacterial species producing carbapenemases, and KPC-producing Klebsiellas had the widest distribution, while NDM producers were very few reported. Here we see the occurrence of VIM, and the only country with red color is Greece, while with orange color is painted only Italy and Hungary. Here it's the occurrence of FOXO 48. Here Greece is green, and this reports this means only sporadic cases, while the main problem is only for France and Spain and England. However, for Greece, the first outbreak of FOXO 48 was reported in 2013, and this means that the color must change. Again, here is about NDM. This is totally green. This means no case reported. There are no a lot of. Only Italy probably has some problem with NDM producers, and England, which is painted with yellow color. However, again, the color of Greece must change. First emergence of NDM producing bacteria occurred in 2013. So this means that the resistance can evolve in Greek hospitals. And the question is if there is any free place in Greek hospitals for the spread and the establishment of a new resistant hangs, like NDM and Toxa48, or Greek hospitals is an accessible environment for the evolution, for the establishment of the evolution of new resistant hangs. If I had to answer this question, I could select the second answer, because there is a high isolation frequency of resistant bacteria, and this means that bacteria can evolve easily. While in an environment like Czech hospitals, the environment seems like virgin, so there is a lot of place to evolve, and biotics can do their job easily. So in order to summarize, what are the reasons for the present situation in Greek hospitals? First, the delay of the Greek system. Secondly, the intensive use of antibiotics like carbapenems and cephalosporins, and the ineffective infection control practices. And the major factors for this is the poor quality of hygiene practices, the high density of patient population in Athens Hospital. As you can see in the photo, this is before 1 month from the second biggest university hospital. And as you can see, there are patients in the corridors because there is no enough place and there are no enough rooms. Also, the frequent transfer of patients between Athenian hospitals and the transient admission of patients from islands or other big cities to Athens for specialized treatment. And finally, what are the effects of this high resistance? Of course, as you know better than me, the high economical cost for the national public health system to treat such patients, the high mortality rates observed for the patients with multi-drug resistant bacteria, and increased bad advertisement of the country because it's a touristic place, and sometimes there are problems. Also, there was an example of bad touristic advertisement for India with NDM producers. But nevertheless, there are no effects for the rest of the community because they continue doing their daily life normally, and they continue going for swimming or coffee or I don't know. Thank you very much.